Leaks surrounding AMD's upcoming Ryzen 9000 desktop series are surfacing online, and they show us details in regards to their models, specifications, and some architectural upgrades. It's expected that AMD will unveil the new series during Computex, with a release to store shelves about a month later. Along with that, there are also some rumors that they'll release new Ryzen 5000 AM4 processors, and it just begs the question as to, you know, why at this point. All that and more to be discussed in this video. Hey, if you enjoy content like this, drop a like, make sure to subscribe, and smash that bell so you never miss another video. Hey, what is going on, guys? Danny here, welcome back to the channel, and I hope you've all been doing well. Computex 2024 is expected to kick off in a few days, and at this tech trade show, you can expect many big players in the semiconductor industry to showcase new products and technologies they're planning on bringing to market and working on. And amongst those companies, we have AMD, who are expected to release the Ryzen 9000 desktop series CPUs, codenamed Granite Ridge. Now, there are a lot of eyes on this series, which is based on the Zen 5 architecture. One of the main reasons for this is because Zen 4 didn't turn out to be all that exciting. Now, that's not to say it wasn't competitive with the competition. It certainly was in a wide variety of areas like gaming and productivity, along with being a lot more efficient. With that said, Zen 4 just wasn't a huge leap over the Zen 3 based Ryzen 5000 series. This was something I had pointed out a couple years ago, and it turned out to be one of my most disliked videos on the channel, but a few months later, there were significant price drops across the board for Zen 4 because it just wasn't selling well for all those reasons I mentioned in that video. Part of the reason why it was hard to entice consumers to get Zen 4 if they weren't building a brand new PC was because it was on a new platform, AM5, so you needed a new motherboard, and eventually stuff like this will be a given, but those new boards did have their prices jacked up compared to their AM4 counterparts, and along with that, pricing on DDR5 back then was just horrendous. A 32GB DDR5 6000 CL30 kit when Zen 4 launched would run you up to around $300, if not even more. Now, a couple years later, prices are much better for DDR5, where that same kit now goes for like $100, give or take. In any case, the overall platform cost was just way too expensive, and while there was a performance jump, it just wasn't as drastic to justify it, at least in my opinion. This was worse when it was compared to the 5800X 3D, because in many games, it was matching the Zen 4 CPUs or even beating them, which does actually complicate things for AMD, because for all we know, Zen 5, while faster than Zen 4, may not actually end up beating Zen 4 3D in gaming. And considering how big of a portion of their user base who are getting these CPUs are going to be gamers, a lot of them will probably just say, hey, that's cool and all, but you know what? I'm just going to wait for the 9800X 3D. And honestly, that's what I'm going to be recommending as well. But we're going to be circling back to this discussion. For now, let's move on to the actual leak itself. This was posted over at Video Cards, and the original tweet got deleted, but that's all right. We see that they've still got the screenshot posted from the original tweet. With this lineup that's shown here, there really aren't any surprises. It's basically what I had expected the initial Ryzen 9000 lineup to look like, where we are getting 4 SKUs with core counts ranging from 6 to 16 cores, the same amount of cache for each SKU, but there are some minor differences. The 6 and 8 core parts are getting a minor 100 MHz bump to their boost clocks. Along with that, we see that TDPs for the 6, 8, and 12 core parts are lower by a considerable amount, and I attribute that to AMD using TSMC's 4 nanometer process, whereas Zen 4 was using TSMC 5 nanometer for the CCDs. Now, there's a lot of stuff that we just don't know yet about the Zen 5 architecture, but you can see from this leaked lineup that there just isn't a drastic change when it comes to the specifications. So that is concerning because whatever performance improvements they show off, they'll be coming from the increase in IPC. Now, when it comes to IPC, you can't just take whatever value AMD states at face value and then apply that to every single scenario because it just doesn't work like that. What they could say is that Zen 5's IPC is up to 25% better than Zen 4, which would look great upon a first glance, but that may only apply to a specific application that works better on the Zen 5 architecture as opposed to Zen 4, using a certain instruction set. But when it comes to gaming, it could just be 10%, which may put them in an awkward spot because then it wouldn't even be beating a 7800X 3D, but we'll reserve judgment until they actually make the announcement. I'm just throwing the speculation out there for you guys, so don't blindly fall for their marketing hype. It's best to look at things with an objective lens. Now, even if performance falls short of expectations, they can at least make this up with some good pricing. However, according to rumors posted by WCCF Tech, Ryzen 9000 apparently will have the same pricing as the Ryzen 7000 series, and I don't mean the prices you see now for the Ryzen 7000 series, I mean the initial launch prices. So you can expect the 9000 series to mirror this, and honestly, if that's going to be the case, and performance-wise Zen 5 isn't going to be anything drastic, then I expect the same thing will happen to the new series as to, you know, what happened with Zen 4, where there will be some initial hype, and then 3 months later, you'll see significant price drops. I do recall that not even like 3 months after, I was seeing the 7950X retailing for around $600, which was like $100 lower than its initial MSRP. One thing you guys do have to take into consideration is that now that the Ryzen 7000 series is nearly 2 years old, it's selling for well below MSRP, where now you can pick up a 7950X for around $480 and the 7950X 3D for around $550, when both of those options would be cheaper than the 9950X's initial launch price. You've also got options from Team Blue like the 13900K, which I've seen just recently on Newegg for $460, and that would be a pretty viable option. And this same conversation will also apply to Intel and their release for Arrow Lake. So, you know, I don't want anyone to think that I'm just picking on AMD here, but Intel will find themselves in a similar situation. But we'll talk about Arrow Lake in another video when that's out. Those are high-end options we were looking at for power users who aren't just going to be using their systems for gaming, but also for productivity. And for those folks, because they're after the fastest or the best, budget isn't necessarily at the top of their priority list, so they may be okay with paying an extra $200 for 10 or 25% better performance, depending on how fast it turns out. But when it comes to the mainstream segment or budget users, they're a lot more cautious of the price, so them trying to sell a 9600X 6-core when you can get a 7600 for less than $200, it's gonna have to look really appealing in performance to justify that increase. Also, I personally wouldn't be happy about seeing AMD sell a 6-core for $300 in 2024. That's just me, I don't know about you guys, but I said this back when Intel launched Alder Lake in 2021 and was giving you more cores for the money, that AMD should probably just shift the SKUs down a tier where you have a Ryzen 3 6-core for $200 and an 8-core Ryzen 5 for $300. That would at least make the lineup more competitive when it comes to core counts, because the 13600K, which is a slightly lower clocked 14600K with 14 cores, sells for $250-ish. And I know some people really don't care about that stuff, they write them off as fake cores or meme cores, but as someone who uses a CPU with E cores in my personal rig, they've been pretty helpful throughout a lot of scenarios. And some may argue that due to inflation and because it's a newer node, you should be happy that they're keeping the same prices, but my argument to that is we're dealing with 70mm square CCDs and an IO die from a previous node. We're not talking about large 400 or 600mm GPU dies. They have a sizable margin on these chips, especially on the high end. AMD at this stage are just taking the piss, and they're doing exactly what Intel did in the early to mid 2010s. We'll leave it at that for now. I'll be talking more about it once they actually release and we get more details surrounding the CPUs. My recommendation is to err on the side of caution going into this release. Moving on from that, I wanted to briefly talk about another leak. This one is surrounding more AM4 CPUs AMD plans on launching at Computex. Now, at first I was like, why in the world are they even doing this? AM4 is 7 years old at this point. It's great that we have, you know, many CPUs released for the socket, but at this point, what else can you do? I've been thinking that perhaps it's because they still have some kind of wafer contract agreements they need to fulfill, and said that, you know what, let's just add these two CPUs to the lineup and have some more options for those who still want to stick with AM4 but are on an older CPU and are looking for some kind of upgrade. But looking at this objectively, these two CPUs really do not have anything appealing for them. The 5900 XT is allegedly the same price as what you can buy a 5950X from Amazon, and the former clocks higher, and then the 5800 XT makes absolutely zero sense, because if you want a non-X3D Zen 3 8-core part, the 5800X is already less than $200 on Amazon, and the 5700X is cheaper than that for $150-ish, and that's like 95% of the performance of the 5800X. And generally, I'd be telling people to buy the 5700X 3D, which is also cheaper than what video cards have here, or just get the 5800X 3D. I don't even think most reviewers will spend time testing out these chips because they add nothing to what we already have, and current options are cheaper. It makes zero sense. Like I said, they're probably just doing this to get rid of old silicon. I get that there are still plenty of AM4 owners out there that will still, you know, continue to stick with the platform, but come on, what does this really do for them? Now, if AMD really wanted to make some waves here, I think they would have been better off just releasing a 5950X 3D. I think that part would have at least garnered some more interest, because because then it would technically be the fastest CPU for AM4 in terms of gaming, and also have similar multi-threading as a vanilla 5950X. But we'll see what the masses have to say once the announcement is official. Alrighty guys, so that's gonna do it for this one. We'll touch base in the next video. If you guys found this video to be informative and entertaining, then leave a like. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below. Be sure to check out the video description for cool links and ways to support the channel, such as using my Amazon affiliate link. And if you're interested in seeing more content like this, then consider subscribing. I'd greatly appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one.